أنا والله أطالب أطالب بتحقيق، أشوف كيف زوجي، كيف ظروف اعتقاله، وكيف استشهد، كيف إيش صار معه بالضبط. ونفسي كمان أستلم جثمان، ونفسي أشوف أولادي.
My name is Iyad Al-Rantisi. I was 53 years old. I was the director of one of the women's and maternity hospitals in the city of Beit Lahia in Gaza. With the October 7th aggression on the Strip, I volunteered to aid the injured who flocked to Kamal Adwan Hospital. I was residing in the hospital with my family as a doctor and also as a displaced person. November 10th, the occupation forces stormed the hospital and ordered everyone inside to evacuate and head south. Initially, I and a group of doctors refused to leave the hospital before evacuating the last injured person to another hospital. However, the soldiers forcibly compelled us to leave. I even left while still wearing my medical gown, having just finished performing a surgical operation on one of the injured. As my wife, daughter, mother, and I were walking south through what the occupation claimed to be a safe passage, suddenly one of the soldiers called out sharply, "You nurse, come here immediately." I approached the soldier who demanded that I kneel on my knees and put my hands on my head as if I were a prisoner of war. Afterwards, I was transferred to an interrogation center operated by the Israeli security apparatus in the city of Ashkelon, where detainees are subjected to various forms of torture. This has been revealed by numerous media outlets, including newspapers and channels affiliated with the occupation. The occupation accused me of participating in hostage taking. After a week of interrogation under various forms of torture, my soul departed to its creator. To cover up the crime, the occupation issued a judicial order prohibiting the publication of any details about the case for a year and several months. Even my family knew nothing about my fate until June 19th, more than 7 months after my assassination.
آخر كلام شو حكيت له؟ حكيت له استودعتك يا بابا، الله يسهل عليه. ما كنتش بعرف إن هذه كانت حتكون يعني آخر لقاء يعني.